Everybody want to win? All right, win stands for something. What's important now? Your opponents have nothing to do with your job and your performance. We're either mindful in the moment or mindless. Cohesive teams always keep their eyes focused on the future goal. What do they want to accomplish? Play to your own standard of excellence. Hi, I'm Dr. Eddie O'Connor. I have spent my career helping people, just like you, overcome barriers to excellence, to be their very best in sport, in business, and in life. And I'd love to bring my message to you. And just like you want and expect from a speaker, I will motivate and entertain, but I'll also give you more. You see, as a clinical and sports psychologist, I've spent countless hours working with high performers, one-on-one, to develop mental toughness using the very best of what psychological science has to offer, to hit personal bests and break records, to create winning cultures. And I'll take these very same powerful techniques and teach them to your entire group, so you each walk away with practical strategies to peak performance that you can implement right away in your next practice, competition, or business challenge to achieve optimal results. Let me help you get past what's in your way.
Sports psychologist Dr. Eddie has been with us before.
Dr. Eddie O'Connor.
Dr. Eddie O'Connor. Dr. Eddie joins me now.
The message to the parents and to the coaches is that expect your kids to be perfect. Expect them to be excellent. We live up or down to expectations. Mm-hmm. But when it doesn't happen, you really have to have compassion. I've got feelings and thoughts and actions going in three different directions. This doesn't make sense. It's nice when they go together, but what power you have if you start to recognize that your thoughts and your feelings and your actions are independent.
Oh, I feel really bad going into game, feeling a little negative. Well, you know, he helps explain why you feel that way and what you can do about it.
Notice that from the moment you get up to the moment you go to bed, your mind is constantly saying, oh, watch out for that, be careful of that. What's he thinking about? What's she doing? Don't be late for this. But we want to be more mindful and aware of, well, how do we engage that and how do we express it and what are the consequences and what's the intention? I just want to keep pouring myself into this. I'm excited to do it. You guys remember those days?
Culturally, we're all about positive energy at Neurofeedback. We try to infuse that into our patients. Eddie is positive energy.
He's direct, he's to the point, he kind of gets to the core of the problem immediately and doesn't really beat around the bush. He'll address it right away, and he has a certain way of really talking to the players and making everything relevant to what's going on with the team. When he was done talking, he said, are there any questions? And I put my hand up immediately and I said, will you be my assistant coach?
Dr. Eddie O'Connor, mental toughness in 60 seconds. If you're doing what everybody else is doing, you're gonna get what everybody else is getting. That's what separates the achievers from the dreamers. You gotta train in adversity, train in anxiety, train in heat like this so that when the challenges arise in competition, you're ready. These are opportunities to get comfortable being uncomfortable. And athletes, let me know if this is the number one thing that you would like your parents to stop doing. Are you ready? The car ride home after a loss. I can't wait to lose this game and get home and see what mom and dad have got to coach me about, to see what I did wrong and how upset they are and how I could be better. Right now, as soon as I'm done, while I'm still crying. If we could teach our children that failure is a gift and a really rich opportunity to learn, and I'm not just being fluffy about this.
Yeah.
Everything that we've ever learned has been through trial and error. And if we don't ever accept this as the reality and really embrace it and make it a safe place for our kids to fail and to try out, to take risks, they're not going to achieve.
Wow.
I love speaking to parents about this topic. I go to schools and youth sport organizations and help moms and dads be the very best sport parents they can be. If you want to be truly elite, balance in life isn't going to happen. Commitment is not a try. It is not an attempt or a best effort. It's not I will until it gets too hard or until I don't feel like it anymore. It's I will, no matter what. We cover a lot of skills in this course, but I don't know if any are more important than this one. If your attention isn't on what you're doing, none of the other skills matter.
He's energetic, he's funny, he's very intelligent. It was the closest knit team I've ever had, by far the closest knit team, and it's just the kind of team that You want them to win because they're such good guys and they want to win for each other.
I always learn something. I'm always fired up at the end, and I always want to go do what he talked about.
How do we build competence in our athletes or in our spouses and our friends? Like anytime you want motivation in ourselves, autonomy, and relatedness. What I'd really love you to remember is this. I'd love to watch you play.
You have the tools, you just have to use them. And that's, I think, a big thing that helps us with Dr. Eddie, because we repeat the things that we need to fix. But it's like, how do we put it into action? Like, how do we use these tools?
I look forward to seeing you guys next season. Have a great summer. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.